We have very few biomarkers we can use in multiple sclerosis, and neurofilament is an exception in that there is really light at the end of the tunnel to bring something that clinicians may in midterm use individually. We have achieved that neurofilaments are fit for use on group level comparisons in clinical trials, for example. But to individualize this as a biomarker is a long stride, still ahead. What I want to convey tomorrow is optimism on one side and reservation on the other hand, because I do not want to have a situation created where a valuable biomarker is falling short in the future because there is enthusiasm that is not justified in use of the biomarker that may lead to disappointment. So we need to build the foundation that will allow an individual use of neurofilament light chain for therapeutic decision making and to monitor disease activity and to give a perspective to patients what is the potential course of their disease. We want to establish a normative database because it's a parameter that is different between young people and older people. We want to find out what is the impact of comorbidities that somewhat occur at the same time as progressive MS occurs, 40 and above, and allowing that we can correct values for these potential comorbidities in individual patients. Another feature we want to cover is what is the source of neurofilament in progressive MS. Is it coming from slowly expanding lesions? Is it due to a brain diffuse neurodegeneration? These are open questions. We do not know about the half-life time and the turnover of neurofilaments in serum, because the achievement is actually the transition from cerebrospinal fluid into serum measurements that allows a clinical application. And we need to know what these basic kinetic parameters are of that biomarker in order to allow its use in individual persons.